Take a look at this O.J. Simpson case. You ever see anything lower than this? Now, I'm not attacking the issue of black or white. It has nothing to do with racism. People like to make a racial issue out of it. It has nothing to do with racism. It has to do with the fact that you have to be mentally retarded in order to get on a jury, whether you're black or white. If you can't prove you're mentally retarded, could you get on a jury? To satisfy the opposing lawyer, in order to get on the jury, you have to prove you're such a putz, you never heard of a case that was in the paper every day for a year and a half. You have to prove you can't see, you can't hear, you don't know your own name, you don't know who you are. That's right, you live in a basement, if you could prove you're the biggest putz that ever lived, you're on a jury. Otherwise, could Johnny Cochran convince them that there's no proof? There's no proof? See, you know that to this day you walk around, people say, so what, there's no proof. Why shouldn't he get away? There was no proof. He only had blood in his hair, in his shirt, in his pants, in his pants. The blood were in the floor, in the toilets, all over the building, the blood. Not that I'm saying he's guilty. It could be that he's innocent. It could be. I'm not saying it can't be. It could be. It could also be that this building is in Philadelphia. Johnny Cochran was able to convince them it can't be him because he cut himself that day. He said that in the summation, that he cut himself that. He cut himself that. He played football every day of his life for 20 years. Never cut himself once. The strongest people on earth crashed right into his face. Never cut himself once. That day, blood started flying from every part of him. If he turned around, blood came from here, it came from there. He was able to convince them that DNA is not even conclusive. Now, what kind of a schmuck would believe it's not conclusive? You know how he proved it's not conclusive? Because it's only 9/10 of a 9/9 of a 10/10 of a 9/9. What does that prove? It proves there could still be two people in Honduras who have the same blood. And look who he told it to. They're supposed to judge DNA, 12 mentally retarded people. They're supposed to judge it. They didn't even go that far in the alphabet. They wouldn't know what it is. They're supposed to judge DNA. Do you understand this? Two people in Honduras, that could be it. Do you understand this? Then they told him another thing, that the police department planted everything. For 9 months, the cops had nothing to do but go around planting. His own glove with the blood on it was planted, the sinks were planted, the floors, the toilets, planted, planted, everything. This wasn't a house, this was a farm. They ran around planting. Everybody who came to California, want to plant something? That's where you go. You plant. You believe a whole police department had nothing to do but go around planting? Can you imagine they got a call, there's a drug bust on Tite Street. Forget about it, I'm planting. You believe this? They found a certain cop who made an anti-black remark 37 years ago. You know what they said? That day he went out and he bought a glove. Then he waited for O.J. Simpson to kill somebody. And as soon as he killed him, ha-ha, I got the glove. Not that I'm saying anything about this case. It could be that he's innocent. I have no right to say one thing or another. But the only people who wouldn't know if he's guilty or innocent is Dad's jury, because that jury is retarded. How would they know? Would you pick this same jury, they pick them out to judge issues of life and death. Would you pick out people who are totally retarded to judge anything important in your life? Even if you get an arbitrator for a labor case where $6 is involved, you make sure that the arbitrator is some kind of a judge. He guaranteed you got to graduate college, he studied labor relations, he qualifies on some level as a judge, even in a small claims court. But you got a bill from a cleaner for $6. The question is it a real bill? Is it a real cleaning? Did he get a stain? Who judges it? A putz from the street? You get a judge. Why is he a judge? Because he qualified on some level. Would you take any jerk off from the street and say, schmuck, you're a judge? He couldn't judge a cleaning bill, but life and death, he's the one. He's the one, the same putz you wouldn't ask about a cleaning bill. Huh? You wouldn't trust these people to make a hamburger for you. If you want to know what time it is, would you go over to a schmuck who looks too retarded to answer you? You figure he wouldn't know the difference. He wouldn't know what time it was. If you want to know where's Tite Street and you was on 2nd Street, that's the schmuck you wouldn't ask. But he's the one to judge. 12 idiots make one genius. How does that happen? You understand this? They wouldn't qualify for any job anywhere in the world. Why should they judge DNA if they can't? You have to be a scientist to judge DNA. If you had a DNA problem and you wanted to judge the veracity or the integrity, the quality, the character of this DNA, would you look for a putz in the street who never went to school and say, schmuck, come here, this is DNA. You've got to be an idiot to buy this as a democratic process. This is a democratic process. How come it doesn't work in this democracy on any other level pertaining to any other issue? If that's the way you judge democracy. All right. It's hard work to talk to a guy like you. You understand this? Take a look at George Ito. Now, here's the biggest schmuck that ever lived. And I say this with the highest respect. You know, he had a right to sequester the jury, but he made them into prisoners. Do you know that? Do you people know that they weren't even allowed a conjugal visit more than once every month and a half? Now, are you going to be judging evidence if you don't have a conjugal visit for a month and a half? Maybe you. We're talking about a healthy person. Would you be able to conjugate on the evidence? Here, there's Hakim with blood and socks and schmatters, and everybody is wondering, when is my conjugal visit? Where is this conjugal visit? They show, this is the evidence. Schmuck, you got a calendar. Where's a calendar? 12 horny jurors are sitting there. Do you understand this? Not that I'm making fun of this case, but this was a fraud from top to bottom. But a guy like you don't know the difference. Did you hear the top quality of his summation that everybody admired? That they say he really proved he won his case when he proved that there's no mark on his body. And even the Jewish unemployed lawyers who were on television judging it, all these unemployed lawyers, and all these old yentas who didn't have a job in 30 years, they all said, oh, that was a great summation because he proved there's no mark on his body. You got to be some schmuck to make that an issue. And to buy that there's no mark, I want to ask you a question. If I stabbed you, would there be a mark on my body? If I shot you, would they be looking for a bullet in my head? Who has a mark on his own body? Every murderer say, okay, before I stab you, one for me. Well, Johnny Cochran was able to convince them of anything, because he's a brilliant liar. He can make Clinton look like an honest man. This is the most brilliant liar that ever lived. He's not finished yet. He's going to convince you. You know who the real murderer was? Shapiro. That's right. You know who did it with him? Marsha Clark. These two people. I like Shapiro better than everybody. He forgot who was on trial a long time ago. He couldn't care less about the trial. He was involved with his shirts and his ties and the schmatters. And Johnny Cochran was no different than him. He wore the same thing he wore, but he had it in chartreuse and pink and purple. And they were both marching around like two partners in a haberdashery. Give a cook for stutzer. They said, the verdict is in. Is that for the shite or the tie? What? Well, let's not talk about this. I don't even want to discuss it. It's not my place to discuss it. They had certain witnesses I respect. Makes it sound like I don't respect. They had certain witnesses you have to respect. Remember Mrs. Lopez? You people remember Mrs. Lopez? This was some witness. They said to her, where do you live? This I don't know. Do you have any children? I don't know. I haven't been home in a whole day. I can't. Does he have a watch? I never had a watch. I hate watches. I never looked at a watch. What time did this happen? 10 o'clock. Let's not go into this. This is not why I'm here. But Furman. They were able to make Furman the main issue in the case. Furman is a pig lowlife. We all know that. There's not one decent person who wouldn't like to wipe him out if they could. He is a disgusting pig of a racist. If he walked in here now, I'd bust his head off. That's right. He knows that. Why do you think he don't come in? But let's be honest. Is it fair to make him the issue of the case? Is he the guy that collected all the evidence? This schmuck collected all that. All that evidence was collected by 9,000 Chinamen who were running around in laboratories. Chinamen and Indians were collecting this, and they made him responsible. They were running around. They made him responsible. He insulted people. He's a disgusting pig. But what has that got to do with a murder case? Is that comparable to murder? Should he be the main issue in this case? What's your opinion? I'll tell you what happened. Simpson went free. He's going to get the electric chair. An insult is not comparable to murder. What would you like to have me do? Call you a Jew bastard or chop your head off? Let's not talk about this. This is not what I came into. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that's it. It's hard to believe that this show ever ends. I want to take this opportunity from the bottom of my heart to wish myself the very best. I know all the women are going to start looking at the husbands. Get the car, get the car. Get the car, get the car. But he's still talking, so what? I'll tell you what he said. Get the car. Husbands never see a show because it's time to come in to see the show. She sits down and she sends him parking. He goes parking and parking. He's riding around for an hour and a half wondering, where could you park for nothing around here? There must be a place to... They could have a car worth $300,000, but if they have to spend $6 for parking, son of a bitch. You have to be a place to park for nothing, otherwise the hell with the show. So they park for an hour and a half, then they come in. Oh, thank God, I'll watch the show. Now you're going to watch the show. It's almost over. Get the car. Thank you all. God bless you. Thank you. It was